فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله we have the class from the book of الأدب المفرد للإمام أبي عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري رحمه الله صاحب الصحيح يرحمك الله. باب قول الرجل للرجل ويلك، الباب الثالث وثلاثون بعد 300. This class is from the book of الأدب المفرد of Imam Bukhari رحمه الله تعالى، chapter 333. Saying to another man, ويلك، pity on you، pity on you. Hadith number 775. قال الإمام البخاري رحمه الله تعالى حدثنا سهل بن بكار قال حدثنا الأسود بن شيبان عن خالد بن سمير عن بشير بن نهيك عن بشير وكان اسمه زحم بن معبد فهاجر إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال ما اسمك؟ قال زحم، قال بل أنت بشير. قال بينما أنا أمشي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذ مر بقبور المشركين فقال لقد سبق هؤلاء خيرا كثيرا ثلاثا، فمر بقبور المسلمين فقال لقد أدرك هؤلاء خيرا كثيرا ثلاثا، فحانت من النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم نظرة فرأى رجلا يمشي في القبور وعليه النعلان، فقال يا صاحب السبتيتين، يا صاحب السبتيتين، يا صاحب السبتيتين، ألقي سبتيتيك. فنظر الرجل فلما رأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خلع نعليه فرمى بهما، خلع عليه فرمى بهما. This is hadith number 775 from the Sahabi called بشير بن معبد السدوسي whose name was زهم بن معبد. زهم، زحم بن معبد had made هجرة to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked him what's your name. He replied زحم crowd. That is the meaning of زحم crowd. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said no you are Bashir bearer of a good news. Bashir said while I was walking with the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم he passed the graves of some idol worshippers. He said three times, these people have missed much good. These people have missed much good. Then he passed by the graves of the Muslims and said, these people have obtained much good. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam suddenly looked up and saw a man walking among the graves wearing sandals. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "You with the ox hide sandals, take off your sandals." When he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the man saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remove his sandals and throw them away. He removed his sandals and throw them away. In this hadith, one of the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to change the name of the person if it's not good to a good name. Also, he used to change the name if there is a clear praise for the person. So the ulama talk about the names which should be used is a name which doesn't carry a wrong meaning, like the son of Jesus, for instance. Or the slave of Jesus, for instance. Or the slave of the Prophet. Or the slave of the Kaaba and the like. Not a name with a praising, like the successful one, for instance. Rather, the Prophet ﷺ encouraged to choose from the name is the best, a good name. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned that the name has some relationship with the person. If your name, from the name of the Prophet ﷺ, he used to change is the harb, war. He used to change. Somebody's name is Harb, war. War causes destruction. Even the one in Islam is the highest, is encouraged. Even the person shouldn't wish to encounter that one. Jihad fi sabilillah. But if it happened, he should be truthful and be firm. لا يتمنين أحدكم نعم العدو لا تتمنوا لقاء العدو فإذا لقيتموهم فاثبتوا. Prophet ﷺ said, don't wish to meet the enemy. But if you meet with them, be firm. Don't run and scare. But before that, لا تتمنوا. I wish I would be. I go there. Yes, the believer is truthful. If that legal jihad fi sabilillah comes, he has in his heart and his aqidah to be from those who participate. There is authentic hadith in that. But he doesn't work for it. He doesn't look for it. He doesn't cause it. He doesn't take the means. Work for it. La. He doesn't even make tamanni. What is tamanni in English? La tatamanni. Yes? Wish. Shouldn't wish. Na'am. So, Prophet ﷺ, if a Sahabi's name is Harb, war, he used to change. And it's his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to choose from the names the best. Parents should choose for their children the best of the names. Today, some parents are looking for strange names, regardless of the meaning of that name. know a good name. And the best names, أحب الأسماء إلى الله عبد الله وعبد الرحمن. The name عبد الله is the best name من دمي عبد الرحمن. Then the names attached to Allah, عبد الرزاق, عبد الفتاح, عبد السلام, عبد الحليم, عبد الكريم. The slave of الرحمن, الرحيم and the like. The names of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, Ahmed. The names of the good people, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Amr, and the like. That's more, but it's not a mandatory. As long as the name is, doesn't carry wrong meaning nor praising. A Muslim, the scholar mentioned, doesn't have to, new Muslim doesn't have to change his name. If it doesn't show a wrong meaning, it doesn't have to change. It's not a must. Naam. This is one sunnah. And in the, when the person die, and his soul is taken away by the angels, if he is a righteous person, they will call him and name him the best of his names. The name he did like the most from what people used to call to them. Imagine if you didn't have a name, a good name. You're losing a part of blessings. Naam. This is one thing. We take it from this hadith. Prophet ﷺ, he changed the name of the Sahabi, Hazm, to the name of Bashir, a carrier of good news. Someone who gives glad tidings. Then the messenger, that Sahabi, radiallahu ta'ala anhu Bashir, was with the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day in the middle of the graves. And then he came to the graves, he passed by the graves of the mushrikun. He said, لَقَدْ سَبَقَ هَؤُلَاءِ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Three times. Those, they miss a lot of good. They miss a lot of good. And from that, they miss is that the companionship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed by the graves of the Muslims, and he said, "Those attain a much good, a great good, attain a good, khair, a lot of good." Three times he repeated alayhi wasallam. It was from his sunnah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to repeat sometimes his speech three times. The Sahabi says to be understood, so he can be understood. Three times, not all the time, sometimes. It was one of his special ways, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught the people to convey the message, so people can understand the message. He had many ways. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam itself is a subject taken in the universities. How sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the method and the ways he took يعني, to convey his message to the people. You can get the intention of the people. Subhanallah. He did sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some actions, some movements, the Sahaba never forget about it. And that was he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his goal. So they never forget it. Like the day he was in the Hajjat al-Wada, he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught them, then he said, Ala hal balaqtu? Did I convey it? They say, Naam. قال اللهم فشهد اللهم فشهد أو الله ماذا فشهد what it means witness how he does عليه السلام when he say اللهم يا الله he raise he point his finger to the up to the sky and when he say السلام say witness فشهد he point in the companion to them how many times three times So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, combined both action and statement. And three times. How do they forget them? Before that, question. Ala hal balaghtu? Did I convey? They say yes, which means they were following him. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One time he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was leaning on his elbow. And then he said, اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات. Avoid the seven destroyers. Then he counted the shirk, the magic. And then he came to the point, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قول الزور. False testimony. He said, ألا وقول الزور. ألا وقول الزور. ألا وقول. He was leaning on, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sit down. And he keep on repeating, be aware of false testimony. Be aware of false testimony. Until the Sahaba said, we said, laytahu sakat. We wish if he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, could remain quiet. Stop repeating the word. Why? They had mercy for him. Because they see he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, suffering, repeating the same word over and over and over and over. So how he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, action, and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ماذا, statement. And repeating over and over and over and over. How do you forget them? A man came to him. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, advise me. He said, don't get anger. فردد مرارا. The man asked, what is the advice? He keep repeating, keep on repeating, keep on repeating the same word over and over. What this indicate? How important it is not to get angry. And if it happened, the ulama said, it means you don't act upon anger. You human being is a part of the way Allah created us to get angry. And Allah has rahmah for us getting angry. Otherwise, you wouldn't get your right from anyone. Even you wouldn't get mad with the snake. Snakes would have eaten you. But now when you get mad, you defend yourself. Naam, you defend yourself from your enemy. You get mad. Without that, danger. But put it on the right place. Don't look for it. And it happened, take the meanness. Mada, not to act upon anger. Because the anger is truly from the shaitan. Some of it. يعني, therefore, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, لا يقضي القاضي حين يقضي وهو قضبان. Judge shouldn't judge while he's a man. Hadith Sahih al-Bukhari. You are a judge, you come to a court, and one of the two persons make you mad. يعني, he disrespects you, for instance, and you find you are not acting upon the يعني, Sharia. You really wanted to revenge from this one to destroy him. You are not allowed to continue this issue. Stop it. Or find someone else to handle it. لماذا لأنك? Because you will not be upon justice. You will not act upon عدل. You're mad. You're angry. So, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he repeated the sahabi. Another one came, he asked sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the same question. What was in Allah advice me? Prophet said, he gave that man another advice, not that one. Why? Because they say, the ulama said, Prophet said, he knew this man. He knew this man what he need. Each one need an issue. Each one, his sallam, is going to focus on an issue. And they say, well, كل مقال مقال, and every statement has a position. So when his sallam mentioned the seven destroyers, and he started with shirk, and he only said one time, still laying down. But when he came to the false testimony, he sit down and he repeated over and over, his sallam is conveying a message in that issue at that moment. Special care. Naam. So, alayhi salam, he had. One day he led the salah. Right there when he finished, salam, he go off. He walk fast until he entered his room, his house. Fast. Sahaba, they look at him. They look at him. Then he sallam came back. He sallam said he remember that there was some charity he was supposed to distribute it. He didn't do it. He didn't want that. يعني, so he عليه السلام ordered to do it. This is, it shows the importance of reading off good, يعني making sure someone get his right. He sallam didn't walk normal. He had a wisdom. نعم عليه السلام, he had a wisdom in that he was going to convey a message to them. نعم. So this is عليه الصلاة والسلام from his way to repeat the speech 3 times, sometimes. So it can be understood. And they say, صلى الله عليه وسلم, his way of talk, that his talk could be counted. How clear it was, it could be counted. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Allah gave him جوامع الكلم. Prophet Sallam say a short word, the beginning is so big. Unlike many people, Lord, too much talk, nah, la khayra fi, nothing is good. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. In this hadith also, Prophet Sallam mentioned that from the benefit of this hadith, many benefit is it's not allowed to walk between the graves. It's not allowed to walk between the graves with your shoes. Some scholars said with the it's only with the sandals, that type of sandal, which the Prophet ﷺ named it because of it has this and this. Some ulama they say no, it's general. Don't walk between the graves with shoes, unless there is a necessity. Unless there is a necessity. نعم. It's extremely cold. So no, this is a different case. نعم, but normally don't walk between the graves. Here the graves doesn't mean يعني the corner of the graves, but it means inside the graves itself. Here is a grave, another grave is here, you go in between them with the shoes, no. But if the graves are front and the left side, and then you go into the right side, this is a different. نعم. طيب. In the hadith that Prophet ﷺ, when he saw the man wearing the shoes, and he told him to remove it, how the Sahabi radiallahu ta'ala anhu obeyed the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right away he removed it. Right away he removed it. They are the companion of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He tell them something, right away they do it. No talking back, no looking for justifications. La. And this is what it should be, the Muslim should be. When he finds the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, right away he do it. Whenever the Muslim has this character, his way of life, he hears the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right there he applies, is the more he has, the better iman, a strong iman. Another time Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw Sahabi wearing a ring gold with his hand. You understand what I mean? A gold. He has a gold ring. Jazakumullah. And it's not allowed. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he saw the man wearing it. And he took it away and threw it. He said, one of you is putting fire in his hand in a strong way, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He didn't ask him like this man, throw it. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go and throw it. Remove it by force. Throw it. One of you is putting fire in his hand. Then when the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, left, they told the Sahabi, get it and take the gold and do it something else. Sell it. نعم he could sell it. He allowed her to sell the gold, right? He could give his female relative. He said, لا والله, by Allah, something messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم throw it, I will never take it. الله أكبر. Do you see that? Something Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم throw it, how I'm taking it, I will never take it. He left it, someone else took it. This they were taking it, صلى الله عليه وسلم, his statement, his commands, as it should be taken. لأنه عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يأمر إلا بما ينفعهم. He doesn't command except that which benefit them. They had this عقيدة. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم may say something. Allah سبحانه say something. It's for our own benefit. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد. You the one who in need of Allah. Allah is sufficient. If someone understand he needs this thing, it is his benefit. The way he react is different than when he thinks someone else's benefit. Is that right? I don't forget this wisdom. Allah A'lam is a wisdom. How I know, I always remember. But subhanAllah, from non-Muslim. Can you believe? Yes. Allah gave them aql, worldly aql. He was talking to the taxi drivers. After they passed the test, he gave them the driver lesson. They passed. Taxi drivers. He said, you will pick up someone, right? Give them right, customer. Those customers, they don't care about your well-being. You get ticket. They don't care. They need to reach somewhere. They tell you, let me reach there. Go fast. Drive. Yell on me, yell on you. Even though they know this is against the law to overspeed, they see that, but they don't care about you, he said. What will you tell them? He said, respond to them in a way you make them feel you care about them, not about yourself. How you say you tell them, I care about your safety. Your safety is number one important for me. He said, this person, not only he will accept your decision, but also he will pay you more, he said. Because you show caring about him. But imagine if you say, no, 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 I don't want to be given, he said. Problem. It's a reality. That when the person feel you do this for his benefit, for his benefit, the way he act is different than when he says it as a command. Even check your son, your daughter. See how your child reacts when he sees he thinks there's benefit in it. For what you tell him, to play. Oh, my son, have a fun. Go there. You see how he reacts? Right away you go. Because he sees this is benefit. Tell him something else. Argument, justification. So to explain to him, even when you're telling him, studying and those he doesn't have a desire, that you do it for his favor. He understands. It's yours. Na'am, if he take this understanding, if you pray, you get in this ajr. If you memorize Quran, you get in this reward. Who? It's you, not me. I'm only helping you. I'm serving you. The way he take it is different. The way when he should take, he take it when the way many parents just don't do it. Even sometimes the child doesn't understand. He doesn't understand even what. Do it. I told you to do it. Go do it. Na'am. Sometimes the child believes that what you tell him is even wrong. But he doesn't have a chance to explain. Because the command, do it, don't do it. Khalas. Na'am, la. It's better to explain to him why he needs to do it. What's the benefit? So at least to know that it's his own benefit. After that, if he neglect, that's different. After he understands. But sometimes they don't even understand it. So Al-Muhim. So Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said to the Sahabi, throw the remove the gold ring, he said, Wallah, I will never take something Messenger of Allah Muhammad threw it, and he left it. Here from the teaching of Prophet, this Sahabi Prophet was hard on him. But on other incidents, some other Sahaba, it was the opposite. They did something wrong, even he didn't tell them anything. Rather, those who wanted to discipline them, he told them to leave them alone. Leave him alone. Like the one who urinated in the masjid, leave him alone. He didn't ask him even to kill him. He asked someone else. Because that one, he was different than this one. This one, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, removed the gold ring from him. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knew who he is. He is that companion who, even not taking the gold ring, which is permissible for him, after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, threw it. Unlike the other one, who the ulama said, may fight back. People go there to discipline, he may fight back. He knows, alayhi salatu wa sallam, he considers the result. It's not like what many Muslims are, especially many du'at. They do not care about the result. This is a haq, is haq, say it, do it the way it is. Even if it causes corruption, big harm to you, to the people, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sunnah, innama al-a'mal bil-khawatim. Indeed, deeds are by the end. The hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you look an action or you look a statement, even though it is haq, doing it causes a bigger harm, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to refrain from it, leave it. Naam, he used to leave it. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sees more benefit, do it. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this was his, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sunnah. That some people, he was hard on them, alayhi wa sallam. And hard here means that thing, not cursing them, nothing. And some people very easy. Very easy. Even some of them, they hold his khamis and yani squeeze him and left some sign, scratches on his neck. And he is only saying, La wa astaghfirullah, la wa astaghfirullah, la wa astaghfirullah. And he giving this man what he wants. This is his way of conveying the message. Someone, he received the message through easiness. Someone through harshness. Naam. ولكل مقال المقال. So in this hadith, Prophet ﷺ, he commanded the Sahabi to throw the sandals, remove it, and he did it. And that's what a Muslim should do, unless, as I said, there is necessity in some situations. Because the religion, we should understand collectively, all of it as whole. Otherwise, you misplace it. You take it away, Prophet ﷺ, he didn't mean it. عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم. طيب باب البناء باب البناء وإن شاء الله conclude with this باب. قال إمام البخاري رحمه الله تعالى حدثنا إبراهيم المنذر قال حدثنا محمد بن فديك قال محمد بن هلال أنه رأى حجر أزواج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من جريد مسطورة بمسوح الشعر بمسوح الشعر فسألت عن بيت عائشة فقال كان بابه من وجهة الشام وجهة الشام وقلت مصراعا كان أو مصراعين قال كان بابا واحدا قلت من أي شيء كان قال من عرض من عرعر أو ساج من عرعر أو ساج صحيح الإسناد. This new chapter 334 محمد بن فديك said, Muhammad ibn Hilal said, he saw the rooms of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The rooms were made of palm trunks, covered with rags made of hair. He saw the rooms of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The rooms were made of palm trunks, covered with rags made of hair. hair. Muhammad ibn Abu Fudayk said, I asked him about the room of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. And he said, it is door face Syria, meaning north. It is door faced ماذا? Syria, meaning north. I said, was it one or two spans? Was it one or two spans? He said, his door was one span. One span. I said, what was it made of? He said, from Cypress. Cypress and or twig wood. Jazakallahu khair Abdullah. This was how the house of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very simple. Very simple. To him, alayhi salam, houses and worldly life was a means to reach to Akhirah. Not as it is to most of the people, a means to block him from Akhirah. To block him from Akhirah. This is how the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam house is very, very simple. One time they gave him a beautiful cloth. He wore it. Beautiful. And in the Salah, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam think about it. When he finished Salah, he removed it. He said, give to such person. It distracted me from my Salah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And now some of us, they're very busy with all the time. Fixing the imama, looking the watch. And some people, even inside, the even in the salah, in their phone. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوتِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ لا. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his life was very, a means to reach Akhirah. Not to block him from Akhirah. And his wife is Ridwanullah Ta'ala alayhin, did please with that simple life because they had the same goal. Wife is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened for the companion the worldly means and they improved in their worldly means. They have some more income. But still the wives of the Prophet ﷺ are in the same situation. Some of them felt something, the wife of the Prophet ﷺ. How this? Prophet ﷺ, he gathered them. As Allah commanded him in Surah Al-Ahzab, Ya Nisa al-Nabi, إن كنتن تردن الحياة الدنيا وزينتها فتعالين أمتعكن وأصرحكن صراحا جميلا وإن كنتن تردن الله ورسوله والدار الآخرة فإن الله أعد للمحسنات منكن أجرا عظيما. Oh, the wives of the Prophet, if you need, if you desire the worldly life and it is beauty, come on. أمتعكن وأصرحكن صراحا جميل. أمتعكن, I give you some worldly life. Then وأصرحكن صراحا جميل means I divorce you. When a Muslim is divorcing his wife, it's better to give her something, not to take from her. Unless she's the one who causing the problem. She want to destroy his house. Now خلع, you have right to take your dowry back. My George scholar said rather even more than that, whatever she accepts. Because now you're encountering problem. You have to build a new house and new expenses. But other than that, you're the one who wanted to divorce her. You want to marry another one. Whatever the case is, you feel she is this. But give her something. Worldly, give her something. Na'am. And the Prophet said, وَأُصَرِّحْكُنَّ صَرَاحًا جَمِيلًا and I divorce you. وإن كنتن تريدن الله ورسوله والدار الآخرة. But if you wish, if you desire Allah عز وجل and the life after death, الدار الآخرة, فإن الله أعد للمحسنات منكن أجرا عظيما. Allah indeed prepared the righteous among you a big reward, means Jannah, paradise. All of them choose paradise. So the wives of the Prophet ﷺ accepted that life, no oppression. Not like the enemy of Al-Islam saying if they see a Muslim woman staying in her house, taking care of her kids, and that she is in a boring life, she is slavery. They see a Muslim woman having hijab, having niqab, that she is enforced. A man enforced her, he humiliated her. Who told them this? How can you enforce a human being, especially a woman our time? They enforcing people. Naam. Wherever they may be. Naam. But this is يعني lie on Islam. Those women, Allah guide them. They love Akhirah. They choose Akhirah. That's what they doing. They doing of acts of worship. Naam. Because those kuffar, they don't understand how someone choose some difficulties, worldly difficulties, Naam, where he can get worldly life. They can't understand that there is aqidah, that this worldly life, if it takes you away from Akhirah, the Muslim has that aqidah to leave it away. So he can get the bigger thing. When Jewish man visited one of the Sahaba house, it was narrated, and he looked the house, nothing is there. The Sahaba is called Abu Dharr. Then he didn't see anything. So Abu Dharr, what do you do with your income? I don't see. Say, I send it to the Akhirah, here after Akhirah. That's where I send my income. Unlike these people. It's coming, inshallah, this hadith. Everything they have is in the house. Decoration from wall. All day long. All job is just at the house. Tomorrow backyard, in the morning front yard. Subhanallah, inside the house. Little thing being removed, switching, every day changing the form of the house. Bed. أليس عندكم عمل آخر? Don't you have other job? Subhanallah. So he didn't understand when this Sahabi doesn't have that means. And he knows he's ahead. Allah give him provision. But he give it to the poor. He give it to the relative. He give it, spend it to the cause of Allah for Akhirah. He decorate the house of the Akhirah. Naam. So they are those. The wives of the Prophet ﷺ, this hadith, it shows the virtue of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, especially Aisha, which the Tabi'i specifically asked about her room. Because Prophet ﷺ loved her more than the rest of his wives. And if that worldly life and decorating her house is better, he would have done for her. And that's why he ﷺ, when he was about to die, he asked all his wives to let him remain in the room of Aisha. Look, even at that situation, who man has no desire a woman? He, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, asking them permission. In that situation, even though he, alayhi salatu wasallam, is different than the other man, naam, and whoever do good, the more he do good, the more he close to the Prophet sallam, that his wife is love him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because he is messenger Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasallam. Not because of the worldly life, as we mentioned now, but because he is the messenger of Allah. So even if he is not paying them anything, nothing worldly life, still they wanted to be with him, alayhi salam. So he asked them permission, so they let him. So he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, used to be in those days he was sick in the room of Aisha. rather his soul was taken by the angel while he عليه السلام his hair was on the thigh of Aisha. Then how, what is the ruling of those shayateen? أعوذ بالله. Who repeat Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. But cursing and slandering and saying bad about that woman, about that companion, about that mother of the believers, the daughter of Abu Bakr, the wife of Prophet ﷺ, whom he ﷺ choose to die on her thigh. Are they respecting Messenger Muhammad ﷺ? La wallah, the enemy to him. Wallah, the enemy to him. Will you be happy when someone talk about your wife? Say bad about your wife. Naam. Especially the one you love her the most. You, the one who you choose her from the people. Subhanallah. Don't they understand what they say? And that's a proof that these people originally, they are not Muslims. They are munafiqun, hypocrites. As Ibn Taymiyyah said, zanadiqa. But don't be deceived with Allahu Akbar and the name shi'arat kadhiba. The munafiqun used to say that. إذا جاءك المنافقون قالوا نشهد إنك لرسول الله. They swear by Allah that Messenger Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. Abdullah ibn Salul, biggest munafiq, right after Fajr, right after Jum'ah prayer, he stand by the door of the masjid. Oh, people, be thankful to Allah who sent you this Messenger Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam to save you from his guidance. Friday. Liar. He's not truthful in that. So Hezbollah, this Hezbollah, these names, don't be deceived with it. Hezbollah Shaitan. Because they see the awliya'ullahi haqqan, the companion of the Messenger, to be kuffar. It is what they see. Abu Bakr is an idol of Quraysh. Umar an idol of Quraysh. Aisha lived, a'udhu billah. If Abu Bakr is an idol, is a mushrik, Umar is a mushrik, then on what matter? What Umar did? What is the problem with Abu Bakr? If you truly a Muslim, why you have problem with Abu Bakr and Umar? Who has a problem with Abu Bakr and Umar? Other than a non-Muslim, other than enemy of Islam. We have, Allah gave us aql, we have to use it, logic, intellect. From the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide Abu Bakr to Islam, day one, till he die, all his time for Islam. From time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide Umar to Islam until he died, Islam Muslim, ya Allah, subhanallah. The time of Umar, it was the strongest time Muslims had. It's the time of Umar. Time of Abu Bakr, they were busy with fighting those who left Islam. Abu Bakr was busy with many people left Islam by the death of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Naam. And the time of Uthman, some of it fitna. Time of Ali, more fitna and divisions. Time Umar, safe. Safe Muslim spreading. Tawhid being spread. Muslim getting strong. In a way, it was said that the judges, the courts had no one to come to complain. People are upright. Justice, wise, brave, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hakim. Naam. Until Allah made the Muslim the strong government on earth. His time. No fitna between the Muslims. Nothing whatsoever. Tawheed. Someone who take Umar to be enemy of Islam. Someone who take Umar to be his enemy. On whether? On what? Is this understandable? No. Prophet ﷺ said, حب الأنصار من الإيمان. To love the Ansar is from the Iman. It's from Iman. وبغض الأنصار نفاق. وكما قال عليه السلام. And hating the Ansar is hypocrisy. It's very clear, يا إخوان. Why you hate the Ansar? Those who welcome Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, honor him. If you don't hate the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, himself and his religion. How you love Ansar if you don't love the Messenger and his religion? Why you love Ansar? Is you love them because of the good thing they did. If this is the, how about the muhajirun? How about عشرة المبشرون بالجنة? How about the خلفاء الراشدون? How about أبو بكر and عمر? رضوان الله تعالى عليه. So, but these people, as the munafiqun used to be, are deceiving the ignorant with good names. Hezbollah, أنصار الله, شعارات, Islam up, writing their weapon on a name is الله أكبر. لا حقيقة لذلك كله. No reality. من ثمارهم تعرفونهم. And you know from their fruit. Did they taught people توحيد? To worship Allah alone? Did they taught people the sunnah of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم? Did they taught people what Allah called them to? Of following the companion of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and taking them example? What did they teach? نعم. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all. Wallahu a'lamu sallallahu sallam barak ala Nabi Muhammad. If there is any correction, بارك الله فيك. Any question relating to the topic, سبحانك الله وبحمدك لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.